Okay, I thought maybe I would just give you a little run through as to how I did my little flip book here. I have my regular 7.5 inch square. This is my background, my main page. So you're going to cut yours whatever size your book is, 6, 7, whatever. These, I cut 2 of them, and I'm using the scraps that I had left over from my base brown paper. I cut them 4.5 inches tall by 7.5 inch wide, and then I scored it at 7.25 inch. So I had a 1/4 inch seam here, and I just adhered the two together right here so that I have 4 panels. 1, 2, 3, 4. I wanted them a little bit bigger than the 4-inch that you would get if you just used a 12-inch sheet of paper, but you could do whatever. And then I just attached it to my book here. So this will be my flip. I'll have 4 pictures on this side, and I'll have 4 pictures on this side. Now, to hold it in place, since this is a masculine theme mini, I thought I would make something that looked like a belt loop. Okay, so I took a piece that's 12 inches wide by 1.5 inches, and then I scored it, or excuse me, I cut it apart at the 8-inch mark right here. I scored it at 3/4 inch on this side, and I scored it at 2 1/4 inches on this side. This gives me plenty of room to attach it in the back and run it around like this. And what I will have when I get done, here's my prototype one. I did want to use it because I didn't have the same measurements for you. I just lopped off the edges with my decorative corner chomper. And it will go like this. I think I'll put it underneath like that one so that this flap is facing inward. And then I cut a little strip. I think this is 1/4 inch by, I don't know, 1/4 inch by 3 inches, and I just figured out how much it would go around like this. This will be where the belt goes through like that to hold it. Very simple. And if it's still not sturdy enough, I may place a magnet underneath here and here to hold this part, magnetize it close. But I think it'll be enough to keep this close just on its own. So I wanted to show you this part before I did the decorative paper over the top. But I'm trying to use up the scraps of all of my paper too, and this was a great way to do that. It gives you a nice large photo in the back. Plus it will give you 8 4 by, let's see, this is, it'll give you 4 1/4 by, oh goodness, 3.5. So 3 by 4 size, 8 3 by 4 size in this one, plus the big one. Okay, there you are. Simple, easy peasy, just like always. Bye now.